The National Commission on Violence Against Women have recorded that more than 3 million cases of domestic violence against women occurred in 2021. Right now, the data shows that the high level of violence against women continues to occur in Indonesia. My name is Dinda Isnani. I'm representative of Bina Bangsa Kira Sempena University for Pemilihan Mahasiswa Berprestasi 2022. Currently, the Indonesian government has provided laws for women who have experienced violence, such as UU TPKS, that provide necessary instrument for women to protect and fight a case regarding domestic violence. The problem is, millions of domestic violence cases are still covered by the woman themselves. In the end, it will impact the law enforcement function to implement it in society. That is why, no matter how powerful the law ever created, would not be possibly effective without the report from the victim. It can be seen from the data on how many women report their husband for domestic violence. Most of the women who reported were those who had higher education and also job, compared to women who didn't have a job and also had low education. They tend to cover all domestic violence they suffer because of various reasons, and one of them is dependency. Because the woman don't have a proper education and job, the woman depend financially on men, so they think that reporting their husband could impact them and their children financially. So, it's better for them to be quiet and silent on domestic violence that impacts them. The domination of men could become greater because domestic violence victims tend to normalize the condition, feeling that they are in power in the family, so it's okay for them to do whatever they want to the woman. As the subject violence, the woman will live in suffering and away from the happiness because they think that leaving the man or divorce isn't an option because of this financial dependence. Currently, compulsory education is for 12 years. It makes education free for students in elementary school, junior high school, and senior high school. However, not all people can enroll their education to college or university since it is not free and expensive. So, people need to be independent or be supported by their parents to study in higher education. However, because of the social stigma that boys are more important to get education than women, because at the end, the woman would be working domestically at home, serving their husband, parents who are in areas where domestic violence higher prefer to support men to get higher education than women. This is why it is hard enough to be independent for women. Because the only way for them to be independent is education, and it is not supported by their surroundings because of the conservative thought. Somehow, if a woman is persistent enough to get higher education, the only option for them is scholarship. However, scholarship is uncertain because the selection process of the scholarship will disadvantage this woman to the large number of qualified registrants from the area where children education get full attention from their parents. That is why the opportunity for women from rural area is very small. For these reasons, there is only one way that can support women to get high education and be independent financially. That is providing free higher education to women from area with higher levels of domestic violence. Through free higher education for women, the woman will be more independent, they have skill, relation, connection, and competence in establishing their own future, hoping that one day, if domestic violence happen to them, they will be brave enough to pick up against this action. The bravery of women against domestic violence will be the biggest weapon for the UU TPKS to be effective. Then, the deterrent effect to the doer could be established, and it gives a signal to all society that domestic violence is a crime and it should not be normalized. Moreover, by providing free education for women, there will be a guarantee for their future. So not only will it benefit the woman, but also this promising future could increase the woman's motivation in studying elementary school, junior high school, and senior high school, knowing that their education will be guaranteed by the government. This program will also open the eyes of the society that the education system doesn't exclude women and the position of men and women is equal. This snowballing effect of the proposal will slowly but surely decrease the number of domestic violence in Indonesia. So, by providing free higher education to women who are in areas with high level of domestic violence, will be able to achieve the big goals of SDGs for gender equality. My name is Dinda Isnaini and thank you.